readings taken from the book of Proverbs, chapter 31, verses 10 through 31. Proverbs 31, verses 10 through 31. A capable wife who can find, she is far more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and works with willing hands. She eats like the ships of the merchant. She brings her food from far away. She rises by the distilled light and provides food for her household and tests for her seven girls. She considers a field and buys it with the fruit of her hands. She plants the vineyard. She girds herself with strength and makes her arms strong. She perceives that her merchandise is profitable. Her lamp does not go out at night. She puts her hands to the distaff and her hands hold the spindle. She opens her hand to the poor and reaches out her hands to the needy. She is not afraid for her household when it snows, for all her household are clothed in crimson. She makes herself offerings. Her clothing is fine linen and purple. Her husband is known in the city gates, taking his seat among the elders of the land. She makes linen garments and sells them. She supplies the merchant with sashes. Strength and dignity are her clothing, and she laughs at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. She looks well to the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her happy. Her husband too, and he praises her. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a share in the fruit of her hands, and let her works praise in the city gates. This is the word of the Lord. Our processional hymn is number 89, Joyful, Joyful, We Are Joyful.
Thank you. Father God, we thank you for this beautiful day, rain and all, and for opening the doors of your house so that we can come together and worship. On this Sunday, we celebrate Mother's Day. Woman is your creation to nurture us in your way. Bless us as we enter into worship and celebration. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
May stand and greet one another.
Yeah.
power that the women of our church and the world give and bring hope and renewal to the world. So often we forget about all the wonderful and fine people that serve and work in many wonderful ways. Talk about even at the young age, the powerful voice.
That's what.
Say, and you thought I was Nazi. My grandmother's even Nazi. So we get to recognize two moms today. Now I want to say, who is our most senior mom present today? So let me start with, do we have any moms over the age of 90? Okay, yes we do. Viola, so happy Mother's Day to you. Right, you know what, you're 91? 91, so under 25, there in your church. You know you're far from this category. Now, grandmotherhood might be a different story, but. Okay, any mothers under 25? 26? 27? 28? 29? I know one mother's here at 29, any other 29? Now my last service, you have to understand, I had two people vying for this plant. They were 4 days apart. And the time comes, like, which one is older and which one was younger there. So that was really tight, you know. And people said, no, no, it should have been her. No, it should have been her. Finally came up with the right woman who got it. So that's really close. So Crystal Wilson, get the plant for the youngest. Now let us join together in prayer. Let me share with you some of our prayer concerns. As you know, yesterday we bid farewell and set off to glory at Oldswell. She was a longtime member here and she died at 97. She would have been 98 if she lived here now, but we took her out to sea yesterday. First time I had a sea burial in all these years. So took out her ashes and buried her at sea. And off below Kate and I, we left from Wildwood and went out there. And it was quite rocky at the burial. For children who were like in their 60s, maybe young 70s, were kneeling at the back of the boat, and the suns came out so bright at the dumping of the ashes there into the sea. And it was a beautiful time, and came back and had a reception right back there on the dock. The boat picked us up right on the dock where the restaurant was. So it was a nice day of celebrating and sharing together Evelyn's long and healthy life there. Also, today we're saddened with the passing of our own Beth Welker, who died on Friday morning, long after 1 a.m. in the morning, after a long and courageous battle of 14 years with cancer. But she made it to her 52nd birthday there, and she had set goals in her life to make it to that next step. And her last goal was that her boys would be home, finish their exams at college, and Josh would fly home from Florida, and she made it to that point, and even a little time afterwards. So remember the Welker family and the Dalton family at this time. First service will be near the sanctuary on Tuesday morning at 11 a.m. So if you're able, please come on out and share in the celebration of life on Tuesday. Also remember Donna Clark, who was in the hospital again with pneumonia this month, and she had been in with something a couple of weeks prior. Bernie Moll had been in and out of Inspira Hospital this week, and Bernie's growing weaker, so she's a member here in Pittman, and if you ever get a chance to get to Pittman Manor, stop to see her and Ida Parker, both a member here in Pittman Manor. Continue to remember that family as her doctors work with her and her illness. Alan Hennessy, who's still in the hospital, he has non-Hodgkin's lymphoma and will be on chemotherapy, and he has to stay in the hospital so long with the start of chemo there. So a young couple, just not married that long, and expecting their first child in September. So surround them in your thoughts and your prayers, him and Nikki and the family as they struggle through this illness together. And also, Pinky Mikey, who is near the end of her life, she She is not able to swallow food now, and so she's on gentle care now for the next few days. And she was a long-term secretary here in that church, and was born and raised in the life of this church. So remember Pinky and her family during these last days. May we pray together. Loving and gracious God, we thank you for this day that you have allowed us to gather to worship and honor you. We thank you for all the women of our church who seek and serve you and give leadership in this church, in the community, and in the world. We thank you for the leadership of women around the globe and for the blessings of women this day. And for those who have had the joy of being parents, whether it's by birth or by being godparents, adopted parents, friends, aunts, whatever the category is, we thank you that you have gifted so many people to care and love in such special ways for those around them. But I know there are others who are hurting this day, those who have been unable to have a child after they yearned to have one for so long, for those who have broken relationships and the family relationships, we pray for your peace and your strength for them. Lord, may your love just surround each woman here today, that they know your peace and your strength and the joy of your love in their hearts. And Lord, we also remember the needs of those among us. Hear now as we lift up the names of those on our hearts today.
Christ University.
Amen.
And we also rejoice in all the joys of life, and hear now the joys that you have given to us and blessed us with in our lives. Christ in your mercy.
Amen.
We thank you and praise you for all the gifts of life and for your love that just fills us to overflowing, and may we truly bear witness to your love in all that we do, as we pray the prayer that our Lord taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
And now we will have Gloria Lethero come and continue to lead us in worship.
At this time, I'm going to ask the ushers to pass out the ritual of friendship. And if you will, just, if you haven't already done so, just put in your email address and a cell phone and your cell phone number. And before we give our offering, let's pray. God, you have given us so much. On this special day, we thank you for those women in our lives who have loved us, nurtured us, and taught us of your unending love. Please accept our gifts and offerings, bless them, multiply them, and use them for the furtherance of your kingdom. Amen. Ushers.
mental bandwidth 3 years ago. She was here at morning worship. A good friend, she and Jeff are a great dynamic duo, and Jeff brings his greetings to us. She's unable to be here, but Sue's on this massive tour, and she had some time in, and 2 months ago she sent me a note saying, can I come for Mother's Day? So originally I have a fifth scheduled to preach. I said, you mind stepping back for next year? So already lined up for 19 if I was speaking for Mother's Day. So Sue's here, we're glad to have her. It's like having an old friend back in town here to share the word with us today. At the end of the presentation, we will be taking a look.
He's a good man, isn't he? Yes. Yeah. He didn't even pay me to say that, so that was good. I'm so honored on Mother's Day. There's always this great, as we've shared in the first two services, there's a wonderful expectation, and at the same time, there's a little bit of an apprehension. Because many of us have had mothers that have gone on, and many of us have struggled, maybe even biologically, giving birth to children. But I got to tell you this, we're honoring all women today. This is all women we're honoring today. We give all women. I love the oldies. How many here are oldie? Let me see your hand if you're an oldie. We all
are.
Mary can raise her hand now. That's right. Oh my. This was my mother's all-time favorite song. And I sing it in honor for her birthday. My heart can see when I pause to remember a heartache here is but a stepping stone along the path that's winding always upward. This troubled world is not my final home, but until then, my heart will go on singing. Until then, with joy I'll carry on. Their value if we recall they're borrowed for a while, and things of earth that cause this heart to tremble remembered there will only bring a smile. But until then, my heart will go on singing. Until then, with joy I'll carry on. have all of my technologies up here. Thanks to Mike in the back. He's making me sound better than I deserve.
That's it.
And I pay him 35 cents an hour. So the irony is that I wrote a song that talks about texting, and my children gave me my first iPhone about 10 years ago, and I had to learn to text because they said, "Mom, don't call me anymore. Text me when you want me." Have you heard this, right? So my son texted me and said, "Let's try it." All right, so I sent him my first official text. Now remember, it's a decade ago. And I said something like, "Hi, honey, I'm flying into Philadelphia. Pick me up at the airport. I'll take you out to dinner. Love, Mom." It took me an hour and a half to text him. So he responds and says, "LOL." Like, then he says, "ROFL." He's using all these crazy acronyms that I didn't know what they meant. So finally, I answered him back. I said, "Okay, ROFLCGU. Roll on floor laughing, can't get up. Now we can come and rescue your mother." So anyway, I laugh at this because we are in this whole craziness of the acronyms and the abbreviations. You know, we have now, I used to, back in the 70s, I sang for all the youth events. Now I'm doing all the senior events. And ironically, I'm singing to the same people. But you know, we have adult-aged texting codes now. You know that, right? So if I was to say BFF to you, what is that? Best friend forever? No. Best friend fell. How about BTW? By the way, no. Bring the wheelchair. That's right. My favorite one, though, you've heard of BYOB, which is, well, there's a texting, adult texting now, BYOT. Bring your own teeth. And how about TTYL, which would be what?
Talk to you later.
Good, no. Talk to you louder. So my son, like I say, we go back and forth so many times on texting. Have you ever sent the wrong text to the wrong person? I actually sent a text to a woman that and I was sharing with my girlfriend that she had a very unusual name. And I was trying to use Siri to tell Siri what her name was. I'm just going to tell you her name. You go from there, because I'm not going to tell you what she said. I said, "I think her name is Regina Snelling." Okay, we're not going to even go there. Just make up your own. But I'm not even going to tell you what Siri put on that one. And the worst part about it, I heard the... Picture this, I sing around the world. I was in this wonderful Chinese Malaysian church, in Karis Church in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. One of the most exciting churches I've ever been to. Oh, they were just amazing. And I sang a song that I wrote called LOL. If I was to say LOL to you, what does LOL mean?
Laugh out loud.
Lots of love. The first service I said, "Loose old ladies." I don't know if they like that. But this is what I love about the culture represented. You know, isn't it wonderful, the New Testament church? We have many diverse, wonderful people from all over the world, and I love it so much. And I was singing this song, and the pastor, I was trying to get the congregation, they're very, very Chinese, wonderful, gloriously intelligent, they're off the charts. But every time I'd say, LOL, what would come back was, RRR. They couldn't pronounce their L's very well. So I go, LOL, they go, RRR. And so the pastor got up after I'm done, and he says, "Suma Valley Sali, we mix up the L and the R. It's not our fart." So I was the only one laughing. I just let it go. I told the contemporaries, you know, we were a lot looser over there. Visit the second service. It's wacko over there. I'm just saying. And I told you about my friends that have a bluegrass group. They go to Beijing every year and they take their bluegrass gospel. Who would even know that the Chinese love bluegrass, Americana music, but they just don't have not very good rhythm, you know? And so the pastor got me, was so mad. He said, "This American group, come on, from America, and you know Crapperton? You come up on a stage and you Crapperton right here. Can't write this stuff, I'll tell you. So, all that to say, you're going to be the LOL Tabernacle Choir. Now, don't be smart like the other group that just went, I went LOL, they went RR. So, LOL. Means joy restored. LOL.
LOL.
Live out loud.
Live out loud.
So where were you last week when I was with the Baptist? Live out loud, because here's the best LOL of all. Because he's still Lord of Lords. Let's give Jesus a praise and glory. Or three-letter abbreviations. L-I-L-U-V-G-O-D, not C-N-N or N-B-C. So I-S-I-T and watch T-L-C and E-A-T of B-L-T. There's an A-P-B in the U-S-A. Truth is surely M-I-A. Well, that's T-M-I. For those in D-C who need a spiritual E-K-G. S-O-S. No, E-S-P, my S-I-N, well, R-I-P, I got the S-O-N, and C-B-N, and F-O-X, and T-B-N, so B-F-F, and S-I-S, this D-A-Y is H-I-S, by F-A-X, or G-P-S, A-O-L, or U-P-S. Your music's not very churchy. And I think she thought she offended me, and I said, no, you're right. And I said, that's pretty awesome, actually. But what a gift to be able to sing unto the Lord a new song and to give praise and honor to Him. And I grew up in an era where all of my friends were listening to the Beatles, and I was with my grandfather listening to all of his 78s of Tommy Dorsey, Rosie Clooney, and Doris Day. So I have the combination of the both in my system. I love all music, but I'm so grateful at 62. I know that shocks you. I'm so grateful. And I think about my mother. My mother would always sit on the front row when she would travel with me. I shared last night on Facebook Live how I literally wore my mother out one Mother's Day weekend. I had three events in one day at three different locations. I had a breakfast, a luncheon, and a dinner. And I hauled my mother all over South Jersey, setting up the equipment, singing for an hour and a half, preaching, whatever, taking all the equipment out, loading it in the car. That was the first time, getting to the other location, setting all that up, doing the same thing three times. She finally looked at me and she said, so you want to do this for a living, huh? And then she found out how much money I made at the end of the day. She said, oh, dear God, I'm going to pray. But it's so fun. 300 people were at this wonderful event in Chambersburg a few weeks ago, and unfortunately, a 99-year-old woman passed away while I was singing on the fifth row. Now, it's not funny, but it kind of is in a way. Let me just tell you why. Because I was singing the song, until the day, it's not like Ethel Merman, God calls me home, and she went, ah! That was it. And so, but she just told her sister, who is 80, just leaned over like about a few minutes before, said to her, you know what? If Jesus takes me home today, it's the best day I've ever had. So be careful what you say. But the funny part was, now people were, they brought around into the center aisle, and I'm like, okay, what do we do? We should probably pray. And the pastor comes up and goes, no, Sue, keep singing. Just keep singing. Don't worry about what's going on. And we had a few EMTs, and then about 10 minutes later, the ambulance came in, and I'm until the day. Sister Pharisee, all the way in the back, starts heckling me from the back. This is what she says. Sue, I think it's terrible that you keep singing. Shouldn't we be praying for this woman? And the pastor the whole time goes, just keep singing, Sue. Just keep singing. I think it's awful. I think it's disrespectful, Sue, that you keep singing. Just keep singing, Sue. Just finally, a nurse comes up to me, and she comes up on the side, and she goes, and she looks at me, she goes, don't worry, she did. She did. I was so conflicted, and I kept singing, but how many know what a way to go? She was in the presence of her great-granddaughter and her great-great-granddaughter and her sister, and she saw Jesus while we were singing until then. We keep singing, Sue. So I'm not taking up a boatload today, just gonna tell you. Just take a deep breath. Nobody dying on me this morning, all right, because we're messing me up for quite a But the glory of the Lord is risen today. And I know, like I said, we talk about Mother's Day. We talk about how wonderfully empowering it is. And it is as a woman in ministry to be able to share Jesus. There was no one that freed a woman any greater than the words of Jesus Christ. And I don't stand with any other authority than Him. And I'm just so grateful to be in His presence and to know that He is Lord of Lords of all things. By far, the greatest message that I can leave with you today is what I believe to be one of the greatest stories ever told. And that was one talking about the aroma of Christ in 2 Corinthians 2, chapter 2, verse 15. It says, we are literally the aroma of Christ. When my mother when my brother and I were little, my mother would often say, come over here before Friday because we'd only get a bath twice a week. How many remember those days, right? And why did we get a bath on Saturday? Oh, because church is the next day. We had to smell good, right? So by Friday, getting on the bus, we were pretty ripe. And my mother would grab us, and she'd grab my brother and I, and she'd hold us, and she'd smell to us. Oh, don't you dare leave this house unless you're smelling good. And that would go on and on and on. And I read into the scripture where it talks about how we literally are the fragrance of Christ. And to some, were very offensive. For those that really don't know the spiritual realm, we can be very offensive in the spirit realm by the aroma that we give off, metaphorically. But my mother had a very powerful experience in Southgate Nursing Home in Carney's Point, not too far from here. In my mother's last stage of life here, she gave off an incredible scent. We would walk into that room and we'd say, there is no way that mom should be smelling this good, because for one thing, you know, she's dying of multi-system failure. But my mother prayed that she would never stink it up. So much so, one day we were in the kitchen in the 60s. We had one of those old Westinghouse refrigerators with the heating elements exterior on the inside. My mother was convinced that there was a dead mouse in that kitchen because she smelled it. We didn't see it for years until that refrigerator died and we wheeled it out. And all the way at the top of the heating element was a fried mouse holding on for dear life. And my mother goes, aha, I told you I smelled that mouse. My mother was all about this, all about the nose. And when I go back and I look at scripture, I realize that my mother was being honored even unto death with an amazing spiritual presence. So much so that it was documented there in the nursing home. There's a little plaque that says, all honor and due respect to Naoma Beatty, who lived her life never stinking it up unto death. Here's what happened. It's a true story. Mary was the night nurse, and she called me, and she said, oh gosh, Sue, you gotta get over here. Your mother paid somebody to bring some potpourri or some glade stickups. And my brother and I, we could not find one thing in her room. All my mother was doing was this, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And Mary, the night nurse, who didn't know God, didn't care about God, hadn't been to church in years, was very offended by that. And she said, it stinks in that room. Of course it does. Because it says this, to some, because of Christ, we give off a sweet scent rising to God. But those on the way to destruction don't get it. They treat us more like the stench from a rotting corpse. And then Joan, my girlfriend that I've known since 1963, she walks in. She's a believer. She walks in my mother's room and goes, isn't this awesome? It smells like orchids. I feel like I'm in Longwood Gardens. It smells like gardenia. It smells like lavender. But where is all that smell coming from? All your mother is doing is just praising God. And finally, Mary says, does she need anything for pain? Totally missing it. I said, I don't know. Let me ask. So I said, Mom, they want to know, do you need anything for pain? Here's my mother. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Don't bother me now. Jesus, Jesus. And she would say to me and my brother, as we were kids, for sure, don't you leave this house unless you're smelling good. Get in that bathtub, scrub yourself. You put some of that instant shampoo, which I love, that powder stuff on your hair. Cover up all that. Don't you dare smell badly. And you know, today I think about all of us. I pray to God for a spiritual awakening that we won't stink it up. I praise God every single day that He is bringing a fragrance, maybe metaphorically, around you. Maybe He's bringing a fragrance that is incredibly lived out by God's amazing direction and guidance. Bringing step by step into the inner circle, causing people to stop and breathe in exquisitely the fragrance of Christ because of your attitude, because of your demeanor, because of your insistence that God be number one in your home. It's an amazing thing. Ephesians 5:2 says, be imitators of God. Therefore, as dearly loved children, live a life of love just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and a sacrifice to God. That's what I want to be like my mom. They wheeled her body out of room 109 Southgate Nursing Home for the last time. And Gail Giordano from Adams Funeral Home there in Pensgrove, my girlfriend for almost 44 years, picks my mother's body up and puts it in the back of the hearse on that Thursday morning. And Gail calls me and says, are you on your way? I said, I'm on my way. She says, "Sue, I got to tell you something. Dolly and I are sitting in the front of this hearse. We're driving and we're crying. We've known your mother for 52 years. But there's something strange going on in this hearse. It smells like lavender, but then it smells like lilac, but I don't know, it's kind of like orchids or something. We asked Bill if he used the hearse yesterday as a flower car, and he said he would never use the hearse as a flower car. He doesn't like to get the flowers stuck into the tracks where they wheel the casket out." She said later, "Your mother's body smelled like a bouquet of roses, which should have never happened." For those of you that work in hospice, for those of you that understand the medical profession, when a person is passing away gradually of multi-system failure, my friend, a miracle happened that night in Salem County, New Jersey. So much so, it was documented. A woman who suffered greatly in her body, but always wanted to be a blessing to others, her body gave off an aroma. Here's what I'm saying to you today. When you walk in the room, Mom, I pray in Jesus' name that you're the fragrance of Christ to your kids. And don't you dare leave this house unless you're smelling good. Let's pray. Thank you, God, for your power. Thank you for your anointing. Thank you, God, for giving this wonderful day to celebrate women all across the world. And we give you praise and we give you honor, for truly, you are our beloved Savior. And we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
to have a good time today. Roshan, sir, clap the way for you there today.
I guess from this room?
Maybe after church. Oh, and there's some old DVDs, and there's your book out there before you can check them out on the way out if you wish. A great opportunity. Sir, thank you for coming once again. Love you. I'm so glad to have you here. Now, as our ushers come forward, we'll receive a love offering for Sue and her ministry. The ushers will pass it on, and then at the conclusion of the offering, I will lead us in the benediction, and we will close with singing two verses of Happy the Homer. Ushers.
Now